episode 2 of Manchild. We're here, where are we, Dan?
We're at Southend on Sea, innit?
We're a couple of fashion icons here at Southend, and today we are testing the e-boards. What are you on?
I'm riding the Evolve GT Bamboo.
And what am I on?
You are on the E-GO 2 from Yunnec.
So the plan is today to give both of these boards a little bit of a review and then do a comparison test, which one you might want to buy for yourself. What do you reckon, Dan?
Well, yeah, we do understand, you know, that like these boards are grossly different in price, but you know, we thought that was quite a cool idea to review them, really. You know, it's one of these guys is going to be for the proper enthusiast. The other board may be for someone that's just beginning or maybe working on a bit of a lower budget. But hey ho, you know, they're two amazing pieces of equipment that we're looking forward to reviewing here today.
So yeah, let's chuck it into a little bit of action now, and then Dan is going to tell you all about the technical specifics of these two boards here. Let's do it. Okay, so we've just stopped here, we're still in Southend, we've just been riding down towards the pier and we found this hill. So we're going to do our first test of the day, the hill climb test. Daniel, would you like to explain the test here?
Right, okay, so obviously when you're riding your e-board, okay, you don't want to be getting off climbing up hills. As boards, the generations move forward, everyone's claiming crazy percentages. The Evolve claims a 25% incline in GT mode of around 100 kilogram rider. And guess who's around 100 kilograms? Me.
And so the E-GO 2 then, my the board E-GO, today, what the, do we?
The E-GO 2, the Yunnec claim around 8 to 10%. All right. So
what are we looking at here in your best estimate?
My best estimate, I'm guessing that's around 15, 16%.
So this is going to be a good test for me.
Yeah, the E-GO's going to. So, but you know.
We're going to take it easy on the E-GO. I'm going to try to go up the hill on the E-GO.
Rather than me.
The man child.
So we'll do the E-GO first. All right.
See how far I get.
Yeah, and this is well, you can kind of tell this is a hot, pretty decent incline, so we'll see what happens.
Who knows? Let's give it a go.
All we're going to do to make this a fair test, we're going to put both boards in their highest mode. All right. We're going to have no push starts at all, just a standing start, and we're just going to roll from here and kind of see what happens. All right.
All right. I'm going first. Let's give this my best shot.
I'm going to push.
We said no push start.
Oh yeah, we did. No, I was going to... Stop cheating!
Right, here we go.
Come on!
There we are. We didn't make it very far.
Right, before I go up this hill, I just want to explain something really quickly, just while Max licks his wounds. I'm going to put it in GT. Now, when Evolve developed the board, I'm pretty sure that the GT was intended for climbing. It seems to be what they've done is taken the throttle curve, and normally you have a nice linear curve, so you have a really smooth power delivery. But it seems like Evolve have taken that and just gone, yeah, see you later, and just had the power curve seems to go like this. So it is actually, you need to really, really pay attention when you're in GT mode, because it's quite, unless you know what you're doing, it's quite frightening. All right, so remember, Max, how much do you weigh, Max? So Max is around about 11 and a half stone. I'm about 16 stone, okay? So we got quite a lot of difference. GT mode, prepare. GT, baby. I'm still accelerating.
So I just found myself having to run all the way up this hill because my board failed not even halfway up. How far did you get?
I got to the top by like, it was ridiculous. This thing's ridiculous.
I think for incline test, mark one for the bamboo here. The E-GO's still at the bottom of the hill.
This thing's ridiculous. Like, I mean, even on an incline like this, which is pretty steep, you know.
It's pretty steep down there, and then it gets better, but
it's crazy. I have to feather the throttle because it wants to accelerate, like on this hill. And I'm a heavy guy, and this is like, the climbing ability of this thing is insane. Dual brushless 3,000 watt motors. Forget about it.
Right, so mark one for the bamboo onto the next test.
Ding!
Hopefully we can get the ego on the board here. Our friends stay, we'll take a look at today. They all join, it's grey. We're really on our way. Yeah. Right then, so e-board test two. It's gonna be a drag race, a speed test. Evolve versus ego. Ready, Dan?
I'm ready.
3, 2, 1, go!
See ya!
Jesus Christ! Annihilated. Right then, so speed test didn't go too well for the old ego down here. You'll see from the footage, we got annihilated on the... We got annihilated on the ego here. The evolve smashed us. But as you'll see from the footage, Dan, the acceleration of that did put you off balance at the start, and it wasn't.
Yeah, that would be a negative. Yeah.
For if you're just starting on an e-board,
I would not recommend this board for a beginner. You know, and even if I did, I'd say if a beginner bought this board, stay in slow or eco. You know, like I was talking earlier. You were off climbing the hill, but you know, it's all about throttle curves, and obviously, you know, your throttle curve is designed to be nice and straight, you know, and obviously in terms of like slow, your throttle curve will be like this. Okay, so you have a really slow power to a relatively slow top speed, then in normal it goes like this, and then in as fast it goes like this, and it seems to be in GT it's just like this. It's just like instant power. It's like bang.
You have it in GT just then.
I had it in GT
so
just
basically
then,
Dan cheated.
Why?
Because mine doesn't have a GT mode.
It doesn't matter, you've got sport, it's the same thing. But it's, you know, the power delivery is relatively safe. You have to feather, you can't just gun it.
It just drops a bomb, doesn't it? If you smash on that throttle at the start, like you see, I've seen from the footage, you was like, put your balance. You've got to be careful with
it. And that's me being easy with it.
Whereas this, I'm full chat on this, and it's you wanted a little bit more.
The power curve on the Ego 2 is much more suited to beginners, and it is much more user friendly.
But I have to say, when I'm on this and I'm not with you, I'm not racing against an Evolve, and I'm just riding about town on this at home. This is plenty for me. By yourself, you're just cruising down to the shops or.
I maintain.
If you're lazy like me and you don't walk anywhere, this is plenty enough. It's only when you start wanting to get that real adrenaline rush and start racing and messing about with your mates is when you feel like this doesn't have quite enough.
Put it this
acceleration
way,
on top speed.
If you live in San Francisco, you won't probably want one of those. If you live in Cambridge, yeah.
Perfect match. So yep, that's test two. On to the next test. Let's hope. Hopefully, we can score some points on the ego. I really love this thing, so I'm hoping that we can score some points somewhere.
Right. So what we're doing is we're giving a little bit of a carvability test. So we're going to be using all the people to sort of like to carve in and out of, and use the people as a little bit like kind of pylons to actually. To actually carve this board around. Okay, now the first thing to mention is the size of the wheels on the Evolve are 83 millimeters in diameter. The wheels on the Ego are 90, so you're gonna get a bit more of a kind of a woohoo. So you're gonna get a bit more of a smoother ride. But it's also worth mentioning that you can get the all-terrain kit for the Evolve as well. And you can also change the size of the wheels. You just need to adjust adjust it on the controller to see what you're using. But you know what? The carving the Evolve is really nice. It's really, really nice. Sort of weaving in and out of people here. You know, I'm riding along in Eco, okay? And it just feels really, really nice. Feels really set up. These wide trucks, you know, it just feels lovely. Okay, it feels like how a longboard should feel. The bamboo deck is really, really flexible. And this is how it should, this is riding a longboard like this. This is the endless wave, you know, this is what you want. So good. The flex in the board is fantastic. The wheels roll. We've gone on a little bit more of a different surface now, so the wheels feel feels a little bit more vibration through the board, but you know, nothing to worry about. So just gonna use these people to have a little bit of a carve in between, using the brake a little bit. Right, so the first thing noticed is that the board rides totally different. Right, because of the height of the board off the floor, yeah, it makes the ride feel completely different straight away. The trucks being narrower makes the ride totally different. It doesn't make it bad, it just makes it different. You know, this will come down to preference, I'm sure.
Okay then, so we've just done our third and final test, the carve test. Dan is the more experienced boarder here. So he took both boards for a more even test on which board is best to carve and weave and have some fun on. Dan, what were the results?
It was really, really interesting to ride these boards back to back, because it gives you a completely different feeling. You know, the bamboo is just like, for me, is so superior in terms of when you want to carve. The flex in the deck gives you that massive longboard feeling. The wheels on the wheels that come standard on the bamboo are an 83 mil diameter, right? And the trucks are 12 inches. The EGO has 90 mil diameter wheels, so they actually roll over things a little bit better. When you come to drain pipes and you come to those little things.
This track we've been riding up and down here today, it's been, the ground's been changing a lot, so there's more.
You feel
it's
the
not
difference.
As smooth as you'd like it to be, but you can feel the difference between the two, and this does feel better in that regard.
Yeah, the EGO rolls over stuff a little bit better, but when it comes to carving, oh my god, the wider trucks mean that you can lean your centre of gravity far outside, much more outside the board.
You can see it.
Yeah.
More fun on this.
It's just so much more fun, and also the deck being a lot closer to the ground makes it just feel everything feels so stable, and you can just lean the board and you can carve it in and out.
But that comes with experience, because when I ride this, I'm not doing that.
Okay.
Because I haven't pushed the boundaries yet to be able to do that. Whereas this, I'm kind of getting to the boundaries of what this can do, but that's still in my comfort zone. Whereas what you can do on this is surpasses my comfort level.
And
get what I mean.
And that's what I'm thinking. If you've got the budget for it, you know, riding in the evolving in eco and in slow, the power curve is set up so it was set up for beginners. It's really, really nice. And then you go into fast and you go into GT, and obviously it's set up for people that are much more experienced. But it shouldn't take anything away from the EGO. You know, the EGO is a great board to ride. You know, and it is good for beginners. You know, my wife goes out on it, she loves it. And
it comes in pink too.
It does come in all different colours. It's so hard, because obviously we're comparing two things that are vastly different in price, and you do expect there to be, you know, quality issues, R&D budgets that go behind this. You know, Evolve is a very specific company, whereas we know that Yunnec make drones, they make all sorts of different things. So, you know, their R&D stuff that's going to go into their boards is not going to be as much as Evolve. But, you know, and companies like that, but Boosted, but the bamboo is, for me, I mean, I'm a huge fan of Evolve. I'm a huge fan, you know, and their bamboo, to me, you know, is just incredible. And you can go to and one other thing we haven't even mentioned is you can buy the AT kit for the Evolve as well, strap on the 7-inch all-terrain tyres, and you can take this thing off-road.
Ground clearance, yeah.
Yeah, the ground clearance won't become an issue then. I mean, the weights of the boards are the same, but this particular test on the carving, where I'm just carving in and out of people.
Weaving through these people here,
it's so much fun. You just lean so far outside the board, and you can carve but with the EGO, and then jumping from that onto the EGO. Oh yeah, I did have a few sketchy moments. One moment
there was one more than a little bit sketchy.
Yeah.
I nearly put my board in the ocean.
Please don't cut to it now, which I know you're going to do. You know, but I'm now kind of like, I'm now pretty much flat out on the EGO. Woohoo! This is a little bit different.
Explain yourself, man.
Just feels alien.
Literally nearly lost my board in the ocean.
Did go for a little bit. I think that I did get laughed at by a few people. I wasn't sure if they were laughing at my Crocs and socks or whether they laughed at me falling off. Maybe it was a combination of the both. Look at that idiot in his Crocs and his socks falling off the board.
That was the third and final test that we're doing here. And once again, the Evolve has scored another mark there. So that's 3-0 to the Evolve in the tests. Well, but there are other things like the costs and whatnot that do.
You should definitely not dismiss it. Definitely don't dismiss the Ego. It's a great board, it really is. But if you are an experienced longboarder and you got a decent budget, the Bamboo is just like, it is incredible. I mean, the next test we'd like to do is we'd like to go Bamboo GT versus Boosted 2, which will be a much more of a comparable test in terms of.
Yeah, but this test is cheap versus expensive. Yeah. How much different are they? How much better is the expensive one? Because we knew coming in this was going to be better.
How much better it was,
hopefully we've been able to kind of decide that. And if you're looking to buy an e-board, which is the one for you?
Right, so what we're going to do really, really quickly is for some of you guys that care about the technical specification, you know, not just the rideability of the board, we're just going to give you a little bit of information for you. Now, these boards are both very, very comparable in terms of size. They're very, very similar in length. The one noticeable difference amongst the Evolve to the Ego is that the truck width is really is much wider. So we've got a 12-inch wide truck length on the Evolve, and we have only an 8-inch wide truck length on the Ego. So it's a little bit wider, and it makes it feel a lot different. The other thing is what the boards are made of. Obviously, this is a different type of wood that the GT Bamboo is obviously made of a bamboo wood, and this is more of a plywood, right? So there is a much more flex in the Bamboo, makes much more of a longboardy kind of feel. In terms of the motors, the Ego runs a 400 watt motor, all right? Single drive, 400 watt motor, compared to the Evolve, dual brushless 3000 watt motors. So you kind of get the idea that the Evolve has got so much more go in it. In terms of the controllers, I personally really like the Ego controller. I find it much more usable. I find the spring inside very, very cool. I find the braking system really not too savage. I find it fits really well in your hand. There's a lot I really, really like about this controller. Whereas the Evolve controller, the one key thing is it has this LCD display. Gives you a trip computer, gives you your speed, gives you your range, gives you your battery percentage. If you had an older Evolve, the first generation of Evolves, you didn't even have a charge light on it. You probably know, you would charge it, you didn't even know if it was charged or not. And when I contacted Evolve about this, the guys were like, yeah, just drill a hole in it and you'll be able to see the light. I don't know about you, I don't want to be drilling holes in my remote. So I really like the idea of now being able to see my battery display of not only my board, but also my controller as well. The thing I don't like about it is this. This feels really, really flimsy to me. This feels like it's going to break. If I drop it, this feels like it's going to break. Whereas the Ego, I've dropped this tons and it's absolutely fine. Both use micro USB charging ports on the side, so that's very, very comparable. Charge life of the remotes around about the same. Obviously, the motors being the way they are, the top speed on the Ego and the Evolve is a hell of a lot more. They claim 42 kilometers an hour top speed on the Evolve, all right? Whereas the Ego, they only claim 20 kilometers an hour. So it's like over double the speed. You saw on the incline test, because of that, wattage of the motors, the climbability of the Evolve is unparalleled. And that's not just putting the Ego against it. You know, you look at other boards like Boosted and other, a lot of manufacturers are popping up, but not many of them can rival the Evolve on a climb. Apart from that, range, you know, the Evolve claims 35 kilometer range, the Ego claims 30 kilometers. I still personally think the Evolve is a far superior board. But when you talk about it's a far superior board, you then have to take in cost, all right? The Ego is less than half the price of the Evolve, and that's a huge factor. That is huge. It's half the price. You're talking over £1,200, okay, in the UK for the Bamboo. And if you want to go for the Carbon GT, you're talking more. But the Ego, yeah, you can hunt around and you can get, like, you can get it for under £600. And for an entry level board, or for even someone, you know, who's been riding a while, who wants an e-board, it's awesome. And you know, I've never had any reliability issues with it. I've ridden it in kind of the rain. I've ridden it after it rained and I got a lot of splash on it and it was absolutely fine. The Ego to me definitely has its place. But if you want a high-end board, I mean, I'm a lover of Evolve. I think they're incredible. When you want to do comparisons, you compare the Evolve to the Boosted, you've got more of a fair comparison. But in terms of the costing, doing a budget board versus the high-end board, yeah, I love them both. I think they're both really good. So I really hope you guys enjoyed it. You know, it's a bit of a weird test, a bit of a weird comparison, but the main purpose of this was to take a kind of a budget board, like an entry level e-board, and compare it to the Ferrari of the e-boards and see how they compare. There's obvious differences, but you know, they both have their place. I guess the key question we should finish with is the Bamboo GT, or is a board of that price level worth it? Is it worth spending the extra money? I guess that's the question. For me, yeah.
For you, yeah. For me at the moment, no.
Okay.
At the moment, this is my thing, but I know in a year's time, 6 months time, if I start hanging out with you more and we start going out, I'm gonna get frustrated on that board. But for now, learning to skate properly and just getting the grips with an e-board, This is doing me fine.
You got to get an invite before you come out of me.
Well,
I've got a style, I've got a wreck to protect.
We've got to buy some Crocs to get in the crew.
Yeah, for me, the price, it's worth it to pay the extra money. For some people that you know, the financial constraints are there and they can't do it, and therefore the Evolve is brilliant. Really, the Ego is brilliant. So I've got Evolve in my mind. I'm happy.
So am I. E-boards are fun. You should check one out if you get the chance. This has been Max and Dan from Manchild. We'll see you next time.
Thanks for watching.
That was just in fast, yeah? When I put it in GT World, In GT, it becomes a whole new world. Just like Aladdin. A whole new world. A so fantastic point of view. I don't know, is that the words?
I don't know.
I don't know, it sounded good though. Right.
Is your mic?
Ready?
Are you prisoner?
I'm your father.
Roll it.
I'm pretty sure GT stands for...
Just tell us what...
Grand! Because it's mental. So this gives you like all your battery, your speed and distance, trip meter and kind of all stuff like that.
Brake as well?
Yeah, so you sort of accelerate to go and then you push away from you to stop. It's, like, it's got a regenerative braking system, so when you brake it charges the batteries as well. Yeah, I did, yeah.
Absolutely amazing. I've never seen anything like it.
Right, have a good day, guys. Right, just one thing, right? All right, just don't, if you gun it, you'll fall off. Just feather the throttle and get used to it a little bit, right? Because it's like, it's a bit of a different world in GT, okay,
so
I promise.
I am an Evolve and a GT virgin, so I'm going to die.
start again.
Take two.
There you go, now give it some. Give it some, you wuss!
Alright, you're good now.
Right, we're waiting for Max to come down, because I'm pretty sure he's going to have fun. We'll see how far I can get up on the Ego. I'm giving myself about 10 feet. Okay, standing start. Give or take, that trick was called a brown pants